Our first guest tonight is Fatima Omar Khamissa. She's a leader in personal branding who loves to shine the spotlight on you through marketing and certified coach training. She's a CEO and founder of Million Stars Academy. Welcome all the way from Toronto. Fatima, assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam. Thanks so much for having me.
No, welcome. Listen, what's the weather like in Toronto?
Today it's beautiful. It's a warm 26 degrees. And we do feel a bit of a chill in the air, but it's still warm and humid.
It's a great city. I was had the pleasure to go just over a year ago, alhamdulillah, absolutely fantastic. Now, look, you went through quite a difficult time, single mum, divorced, went through an abusive marriage for 21 years. So that must have been quite a difficult time for you, left with five children. What was it like at that stage before we talk about how you got to where you are?
You know, for me, when I got married to stay married. And I actually went through my marriage thinking and assuming that everybody is faking it till they're making it. Wow. So, because when you're in an abusive marriage and there's a lot of emotional abuse, physical abuse, financial abuse, manipulation, you're actually not allowed to talk about it outside. They excommunicate you from family. And there's a lot of isolation involved. So it's a systematic breakdown of your self-confidence. And I think a lot of people assume that abuse is, oh, the woman is going to be black and blue all over. But that's not actually truth. I mean, we were like the ideal family. We would look so pretty and perfect on Eid and Ramadan and Taraweeh. And you didn't know what was going on because I didn't tell anyone. And I spent all that time protecting my perpetrators because I thought, hey, that's what good Muslim women are supposed to do.
Well, look, I mean, now, several years on, things are very, very different. Tell us about the journey of making that change.
Yeah, so that's a great question. Well, first of all, I took five kids, put them in a car and started running. So I was homeless and trying to keep my kids safe for about 2 years. I started collecting government assistance in Toronto. And then what I learned is that I needed to work on my mindset. I needed to work on my belief system, like, who am I? What do I want? How do I keep my kids safe? And my biggest reason was I wanted to show my children, I'm raising four boys and a girl, what healthy looked like. And whether I'm a victim or I am the perpetrator, I'm still going to have to answer to Allah. So why not show them a different model? And why not me be the one that breaks the cycle and creates something powerful?
Now, obviously, on that journey, we come up to the concept of, and sorry, look, I've got my cup of coffee because in London, it's a little bit cold here compared to what it's like up in Toronto. We had a pretty decent summer, but it started to rain now. And as I got into the studio, guys don't make coffee for anybody, but you know, tonight I just needed it just to keep going. But look, on a progressive note, where did the idea of Million Stars Academy come from? And obviously that would have been part of your journey.
Million Stars Academy was actually a dream that I kept having over and over again. And I would say in my salah, like, what are you sending me, Allah? What is this all about? And it took me many years to figure it out that my purpose in this world was actually to teach women how to have money and choices. Because there are so many women who stay in relationships because they don't have a choice. Or they go back to their perpetrator. So what would it look like for us to say, what did Khadija do? Can I have a healthy relationship and have my own money, my own purpose?
Let me ask you a quick question in here, because given your background and the difficulty through marriage, and then, you know, being able to stand on your own feet and what you just said, that, you know, there is a choice. Do men, maybe some of the women, regard you as a feminist and a troublemaker because of that?
At the beginning, they did. At the beginning, I was blocked on people's numbers. I was blocked on people's social media. But I can look at back at my life now, and people know that I am not against men. In fact, I'm raising four boys myself. I'm all about partnership. How do we make this work together? Because family is the foundation of our religion. And how do I stand up and say, I want to be a great servant. I want to be a great woman. a great mom and set an example for people to say, I'm going to show you how you can actually have it all.
So what does it look like having it all? What is a journey that, you know, women need to take?
First of all, I think that there's a lot of missing, and the missing is confidence and self-love. You don't need to be a doormat and a victim to be a great servant of God. You don't need to do that. You don't need to be a victim to be a servant to Allah. You can be a servant leader. You can say yes to your family, to your husband, to your kids, and to yourself at the same time. How do you bring everything together and say, let's work together as a team so everyone is fulfilled, not only in our purpose, in our school, our university, and our marriages. That's what it's like to have it all, to say yes to your creator. And I put together like an amazing free training. I'd love for people to come and see what I'm doing. Check it out. And I'd love your opinion. Like, for me, it's all about balance. Your spirituality.
We'll come on to the training. I mean, so would Khadija radiallahu anha be the model that we're looking at? Because, you know, she was a leader. She was wealthy. She was married to, at that time, she didn't realize, the most, you know, powerful man on earth that we've had in our time. You know, and all her traits, is that what we're striving for?
I think so. I mean, as a mother, as a leader, she had it all. She had beauty, health, children, a great husband. She was a businesswoman, a billionaire in her own time. Now here's the thing. There might be a woman out there saying, I don't need all of that because I have a great husband. And I think more power to you. The point is, as long as you're happy and satisfied and fulfilled, that's the whole purpose of life.
Sure. And now, look, you've got to, I mean, let me ask you something else before we go into the actual event that's taking place. What's the single most important lesson that you've learned on this journey?
Oh, my God. Such a beautiful question.
There's probably many. But let's focus on something that, you know, that really sticks out.
I can tell you one that comes to my mind right away, and that's forgiveness. Forgiving every single person that have hurt me, and forgiving myself for the choices I made and didn't make. Forgiving myself for the things I said and didn't say, and say, if Allah woke me up today and He in His glory gave me a chance, can I give myself a chance to be fully present right now and use my past as a springboard rather than a story that keeps me stuck? Forgiveness.
How do you overcome that regret then, you know, of, as you said, you know, having gone through many of the things that you should have done, and, you know, people reflect sometimes, they get stuck in their history, don't they? They don't move forward. How do you overcome that regret and moving forward?
I look at the story of our Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and I say, did he have an easy life? Did he have an easy childhood? And even he, as the most beloved, couldn't go back and redo his past, could he? And neither can I. And I also look at my experiences and I say, I am the woman I am today because of the training and the university Allah put me through.
Brilliant. Now look, September the 7th, what day is it today? Somebody must
have... my God. Yeah, today is the 3rd.
Okay, so we've got 4 days. Brilliant. Now look, you've got this workshop coming up. It's a 5-day workshop. It's free. Command your business like a queen. I love the title. What will people expect if they sign on to this?
So on day number one, we're going to talk about mindset, confidence, and your past. On day number two, we're going to tell you who is your niche market and how do you identify her. Then we're going to go through group coaching, one-on-one coaching. Then we're going to show you how to use social media. Then we're going to show you what a queen would ask for. By the end of the time with me, you're going to know how to take your past, your skills, and turn it into purpose, power, and online profit. This is the moment post-quarantine where women are home and they're saying, how can I make money while I raise my kids? We're going to show you how to do that.
Can kings attend?
No, sorry.
Come
kings
on.
Can't No, we're doing this just for the women, and we want them to have a sacred, intimate group. There are 1,400 other queens that have joined,
Mashallah.
So I'm welcoming all the queens, your moms, your sisters, your daughters.
I will let them know for definite. Now, look, 5 days, how long every day, what kind of time are we talking about?
it's an hour of training, and then there's homework as well. And if you show up live, there's prizes as well that's happening. Cash prizes. Who doesn't like that?
Absolutely fantastic. And look, where can people register?
MuslimBusinessCoach.com. Just go to that, no HTTP, no www, just MuslimBusinessCoach.com, and you'll see the countdown on the page. You'll see me in a purple kaftan, so you'll know you're on the right page. Command your business like a queen.
Fantastic. Love the title. Look, fantastic work, and really inspiring to see where you've come from, where you are today, and still looking after five kids. We wish you all the very, very best, and we look forward to welcoming you in London sometime.
I'm all there. Thank you so much. JazakAllah khairan. This was great. Thank you for having me.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi. Living the life.